in a valley that never has and probably never will see a McDonald's or drive-through Starbucks. Where rush hour means you just might pass another car, sits a town site that is frozen in time. Chesterfield, Idaho was a Mormon pioneer village settled along America's earliest highway, the Oregon Trail, back in 1880.
What's wonderful about it is when it was abandoned, it was never demolished or built over. So what we see here today is actually what the pioneers built and walked away from. And we were able to restore that, and the spirit of Chesterfield is such a big part of it. You feel the spirit of those pioneers here.
Stand outside the old buildings on a winter day, and you'll fully appreciate the spirit of those pioneers. It's believed it was the harsh weather and difficulty making a living because of it that forced its residents to leave. Mere survival was enough work in itself.
There were very cold winters. The winters here can get to 50 and 60 below zero, and that's very difficult when you have no running water, no indoor plumbing.
I don't know if I can even imagine living out here in this country through these cold winters. You had to supply all of your firewood for heating. You had no electricity. All of your food had to be stored up for the winter months.
Members of the Chesterfield Foundation have been lovingly restoring the town so that future generations can experience this preserved piece of the Old West. Using old pictures as guides, they've rebuilt buildings brick by brick, framed photos of the people who brought this town to life, and carefully kept banners that once hung from their walls. There's something about standing in the very meeting house where the pioneers worshiped, comprehending what it took to persevere.
This is the peg leg of Carl Peg Leg Nelson, and he would walk to town every day on this peg leg, and I just find it to be a rather interesting artifact and a real tangible way of showing how tough these people were and what they were able to survive. If you can imagine us getting around today in the snow and everything, and here's Peg Leg coming down from the hill to visit town or go to Sunday meeting.
As difficult as the living was in those early days, the people of Chesterfield still valued social time and the role their Mormon religion played in their community.
This building was the place where the bishop then collected the tithing.
The old tithing office shows how seriously they took their giving, even when they had so little.
They paid 10% of the increase of their income to the church to do the Lord's work, and have historically. This building was the place where the bishop then collected the tithing. Tithing could be paid either financially, either in money, or most often in Chesterfield, since nobody had any money, it was paid what's called in kind. So if your chicken laid 10 eggs that week, you brought one egg to the bishop's storehouse, to the tithing office, and paid your tithing.
Their homes, which ranged from crude log cabins to stately brick mansions of their time, still welcome visitors who come to learn about this pioneer town. The recently rebuilt amusement hall still hosts dances on summer evenings.
I'd like people to feel the history and the love that was here. Realize that grandma and grandpa, or great grandma and great grandpa, did live here. They did put up with these situations, but they learned to cooperate and help each other.
Although abandoned for decades, Chesterfield helps us learn about history, not from pages in a book, but from the bricks in these buildings. And the music still left in the old pump organ. A ghost town that seems so empty is still filled with stories to tell.